So before starting the match filter, so what happens in the correlation filter? So whatever we have to use the multiplier, so that multiplier, the analog multiplier, then so we have to use the local reference signal. So whenever we have to use these two signals, so time synchronization is the one of the important aspect, or time synchronization is one of the important parameter. So by considering these two parameter, so some part of the information should be, or whatever time synchronization should be required for the in the correlation receiver. So this synchronization should be, or whatever that the synchronization is efficiently occur by using the matched filter. So these matched filter is the digital multiplier, and it can require some reference signal. So these match filters can be mainly subdivided into the two parts. So first one is the detector, second one is the estimator. Okay, so first we have to discuss the detector. So what happens? So here we have to first, the original information signal or received signal is denoted by the x of t. So that x of t or received signal is applied to the, so this one is a matched filter. So this matched filter should be, it is a synchronized time. So whenever with the small t equal to capital T, at that time this switch should be closed. So whenever switch is closed, at that time it can get the observation vector. So that observation vector is denoted by x. So it means, so first received signal, so that received signal is applied to the matched filter. So this matched filter should be synchronized with the time equal to t, at that time switch is closed. So when the switch is closed, at that time we can get the observation vectors. So this observation vector is denoted by the x. So once you get the observation vector, then we again go for the estimation of the symbol. Okay, so how it is exactly estimated? So this, whatever we have to get the observation vector, so that observation vector is applied to the inner product or inner product calculator. So this inner product calculator consisting the multiplier with the accumulator. So means, so what is the multiplier? So whatever we have to get the observation vector, so that observation vector should be multiplied with the signal vector. Here we can get the multiplied signal. So this multiplied signal is stored in the accumulator. So that that symbol or that product is denoted by the inner product. So that inner product is nothing but x of t s1. So means here we can get the inner product. Once you get the inner product, so that inner product should be summed with the signal energy. So means 1/2 E1. So means whatever we have to get the inner product, so that inner product should be summed with the signal energy. We can get the symbols here, 1, 0, 1. So these symbols is applied to the select largest. So depending on the which symbol is selected, or depending on the which energy should be more at that time, so by considering that energy parameter, we have to estimate the original information.